young money, Lil Wayne in the music trap. I make it snow, I make it flurry, I make it all back tomorrow, don't worry. Yeah, young Wayne on the moves, AKA Mr. Make It Rain.
Hello everyone, and welcome you duelists to the next birthday episode. Welcome to the bling party. Happy birthday, Lily Leung. And I hope you enjoy your birthday episode. So, in case you guys don't know what the birthday series is, it's a new series that I've started. So, what this consists of is celebrating birthdays of our fans. And what I will have you do in this episode will be the same as the last episode. As far as the giveaway goes, it'll be going to the actual person who posted stuff about what they would like me to open up for their birthday. So happy birthday, Leung, and I hope you really enjoy the bling. That is right. We are opening a glorious premium infinite gold booster box. Of course, today, in celebration for Lily Leung, we're just going to open one of the boxes. This comes with 3 5 card packs per box. Oh, so I guess it's like per box inside. And on the back, it says premium gold, infinite gold. Includes some of the most popular cards in the Yu-Gi-Oh! That have yet to be purchased or printed as a gold rare. Which I'm super excited. I've not seen premium gold cards. And when I watched people open these, they looked amazing. So, I cannot wait to rip into this box and look at that glorious first edition. So, let's just get straight into it, shall we? On these boxes, it looks like pretty much the exact same thing that we saw in the other box. Yeah, it is. So it contains 5 boxes of the premium gold box. So if you don't mind, again, be patient with me while we open. It says there are 5 cards per pack, and this is what one of the packs looks like. These look amazing. Whoa. Let's be careful with our loot, huh? So let's just rip straight into them and get on with it. I can't wait. I've never opened a premium gold pack. I don't know the trick for these, and I also don't even know, like, what the different rares are. So I have a feeling you guys are going to know more about this set than me. Oh my goodness, look at that glorious gold border. Take a close-up look at that. That is so cool. And our very first pool is Magister Paladin, the Ascending Draco Slayer. That looks so majestic, so powerful, and look at the detail in the dragons, or I'm assuming, oh, well, it kind of looks like a dragon-faced Pegasus, and that paladin looks so epic, and he has wings. I mean, if I saw someone like this, I would definitely want them to be my guardian. I mean, that's super cool, and look, they've got all these really cool, like, speckled, kind of looks like a star type thing going on. Looks amazing. Oh my gosh. That was the gold border. I was totally wrong. I thought that was like it has a gold border, but look at this. It's like a shiny gold border. This is crazy. I'm sorry, you guys. I'm totally admiring this artwork. This is the Cosmo Good Witch. This is crazy. I love this. These are so cool. Oh my gosh. That almost looks like a lightsaber just because of the gold. Whew. I don't know about this. This is crazy. And then we've got a Radiant Mirror Force. That looks really powerful. When an opponent's monster declares an attack, while they control three or more attack position cards, destroy all attack position monsters your opponent controls. Oh, that is interesting. That is really cool. Oh my gosh. Magical King Moonstar. That looks so cool. It's a ninja. And see, I love moon. Like, I love the moon and anything like lunar related or ninja related. That is just so cool. Oh my goodness. I might very well keep this card. It just depends on a couple of things. But that card looks so cool. Like, it's really cool because his mask, I don't know if you guys can see that, but it has, like, a crescent moon. Look at his outfit. Like, I would wear that. Maybe not on an everyday basis, but I would definitely wear that. That is so cool. Oh my gosh. Don't ask him out on a date. He looks rather evil. Rubik Melbranchi. What in the world? Melbranch of the Burning Abyss. Wow, this holo is really, really cool. I don't know if you can tell, but there's parts of the monster that are not holographic, and then parts of it that are holographic. That is really cool. Like, if you guys can see that. I hope you guys are enjoying this, because I'm going to tell you right now, I am totally, totally enjoying this. Wow. All I can say is, wow. I did not... absolutely not expect that. Well, this video may take a lot longer than I thought. I'll try to go through it as fast as I can on the rest of it, but I just had to admire that gold border. I mean, I'm glad I didn't throw gold bordered cards down. Oh my goodness, an Abyss Dweller. Look at that. That dragon like hiding in the crevices at the top, and then it almost looks like a hand, but it's just a rock formation. That is crazy. That is super crazy. And our first gold card is the Cosmo Straw Man. I wonder if he's related to the straw dude on the Wizard of Oz. Probably not, because that just looks so creepy. Just look at that. This holographicness. Honestly, that really reminds me of something that you would see like on Attack on Titan or something. Just something creepy, crazy. We also have this Mistaken Arrest. Oh, wow. That's really weird. It says, until the end of your next turn, after the card resolves, neither player can add cards from their deck to their hand except by drawing them. Okay, well, that's interesting. You know, I don't play the card game. I just open. Oh my gosh, look at that. The Phantom Knights of Tomb Shield. That looks amazing. Like, simply amazing. Whoa. Kind of goes with this whole knight theme that we're seeing play out. And then we are finishing things off with another Melbranch of the Burning Abyss, which this one is Skarm. And again, it's got that really cool holo effect. This one looks more of like a fire type. And the other one looked kind of like a dark, I don't know how to explain it, just a darker. That is just so cool though. At least these only have 5 cards. The way that I'm reacting to these. It's a good thing we aren't opening like the whole case. I can't help it. These are just so cool. Like, when I first saw this set come out and I saw Infinite Gold title, I'm like, man, this is probably going to be really super amazing. So I'm kind of glad. Kind of glad. Ooh, number 11, Big Eye. Wow. look at that attack and defense. That is super awesome. And see, like, there for a while, these XYZ, like, monsters were really popular to be playing. Of course, like I said, I've never played the game, but just going by what I've seen. Ooh, deep dark trap hole. That is so cool. Wouldn't want to be in one of those. Looks really creepy. That is really cool, though. Oh, sweet. Okay, so this is saying when a level 5 or higher effect monster is special summoned, you can banish it, which I'm assuming that means, well, send it to the graveyard. I'm not really sure, though, because I haven't, like I said, I haven't played. Whoa, Dark Mirror Force. So, can you guys comment below? Like, what does that mean? Banish all defense position monsters. And the other card says banish as well. What does that mean? Does that mean sending it to the graveyard where it can't be used? Or is there some kind of new thing in Yu-Gi-Oh! Now where you can use banish? I'm like an old school type person when it comes to Yu-Gi-Oh! Cards. So, that seems definitely something new. And then we have a Tsukumono Slash. Oh, that is so cool. Tsukumono. Yeah. Oh, interesting. Okay. If a monster you control attacks a monster whose attack is higher than itself during damage calculation, your battling monster gains attack equal to the difference between your LP and your opponent's during the damage calculation only, and you can activate it once per turn. So that seems really cool. And anyways, again, with like a paladin type theme, this seems like it could be really fun type of deck to be playing with. And then our final card is yet another male branch of the Burning Abyss. And this one is Cagna. And this one looks more like a dog beast than the others, in my opinion. But anyways, what do you guys think? Comment below and let me know what your favorite card was that we pulled. Especially you, Lily. I just want to know what you guys liked from this. Would you like to see more Yu-Gi-Oh! Openings? Because that is the plan. And also, as promised, here is a code, a lucky code. Comment below and let us know what you get so that we know it's been used, etc. And now for the birthday giveaway. In the comments below, tell us when your birthday is. You don't have to tell us the day, that's just up to you. But definitely tell us the month. If you want to tell us the day, then go for it. And we'll try to get the episode up as close to your birthday as possible. And also, in the comments, give me three options of things that you would like to see me open up on the channel. That way, if we can, we'll try to get at least one of them to open up. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this episode, and until next time, well, I do hope that you believe in the power of the cards. Talk to you later.